And And as well as Jagannath Puri, you see in South India, all the big temples have a Rama. And every year they will go out around and give darshan of the Lord to the
people. And
Oh,
Krishna Krishna Yagurale Srimate Bhakti Vedanta Swami Iti Name Namaste Saraswati Deve Gauravani Vacharine Nirvisesha Sunyavadi Pashchatya Dashakalpe Namo Mahadanaya Krishna Prema Pradayate Krishnaya Krishna Chaitanya Namo Gauravani
Thank you. With a robe as a small child,
Anytime she went to tie, the rope was 2 fingers too short. Again, she got a longer rope, trying to tie it, it was 2 fingers too short. She got a longer rope. It was still 2 fingers too short. She finally found a Krishna, how can I tie you? Krishna gave her mercy, then she was able to tie
him.
So the great sages and rishis wanted to know why 2 fingers short, why not 3, and why 2? It's a secret. It's a mystery. 2 fingers short for 2 reasons. One reason was that Krishna's free will. If Krishna doesn't want it, it will never happen. If Krishna allows it to happen, it can happen. Second reason, the devotee's love. If the devotee has love, then maybe Krishna will allow himself. Krishna is always in the tent, but sometimes by love, he allows himself to be tied down. According to how the devotees approach Krishna, he
reciprocates.
So Lord Chaitanya, because he was of course his Krishna himself, and he's in the Buddha Radharani, he's approaching the Lord as a devotee. And in that loving mood, then Lord Chaitanya went forward very happily. You give your love to Krishna, he will reciprocate with you. Give your love, give your surrender, as Sadhu Maharaj said, and the Lord will give you all the blessings. So this Ratyatra is a great opportunity because we get to be menial servants of the Lord and pull him just as if we were his horses. How does it feel to be a horse of the Lord? How does it feel to be a horse of the Lord?
Bhagavan ke aur budhi baari ye pade humke upar mein nahi.
How do you like to pull the Lord?
Kitne ke Bhagavan ke dikha pull the Lord.
Who likes to pull the Lord? You see, see how brother Krishna is. He's riding in a chariot and everyone is pulling him. But we're having so much fun that we like to pull him.
Krishna, you are the Prince of the Mahat. Our very welcome to the Mahat. Hello, you are the Prince of the
Mahat. I think Malaysia is a special place because here there are more Ram Yatras per population.
Malaysia is a special one of the Mahat. Malaysia is a very important one of the Mahat.
In Jagannath Puri, you only have 1 month left to prepare.
Jagannath Puri, you are one day to prepare.
But here, there are so many Rajyantras
only.
So, this is a very special place. But Jagannath is giving you mercy many, many times over. Like that, in our life, we should also pull the
Lord
by hearing all these instructions. Doing what he says. Chanting his holy name. Spreading his glory. Distributing his prasad to the hungry. Building his temple. Distributing his books. Telling people about their real relationship with the Lord. This way you can also be pulling Jagannath by pulling his instructions. Just in conclusion, I wanted to say one thing. That we have lots of young people who participate in Rajyatras and lots of young people who are participating in Krishna consciousness all over the country. I was there in England. They have a program for the young people called the Bhāgavatam. This started many years ago when they tried to close down the Hare Krishna temple from the public, and all the youth around the community, they marched in public and they made demonstrations and they were very active to protect the temple. Now they got permission from the government and everything is peaceful. But the Pandava Sena still exists, and it's a youth group of all the Hare Krishna young people, children of the homies and other young people who are practicing Krishna consciousness. Probably from 12 years of age up to 30, 29 or so, people are members of the Bhagavatam scene. And they have different Bhagavatam scene groups. And they meet together and they help the young people to be engaged in Krishna service. I was thinking that this kind of program may be very useful also in Malaysia. There are a lot of young people, and some of them don't have so much association with other young people in Krishna consciousness. I just wonder what you thought, whether you thought this would be a good program here in Malaysia. They have a youth group program like the Bhāgavatam.
The Bhāgavatam is one of the
How many think this would be a good idea? Okay, we have another one. How many of the youths would participate in such a program?
You think your name is coming back and then you will be able to.
So I'll discuss it with the national executive here in Malaysia and see what we can do to get a branch, get our own nation part of the SENA organized, which can do a lot of nice services for this time, encourage the youth and youth-oriented programs.
If you have a case of the
Thank you. Nirvisesa sundaratvaschatya visadarame namo mahavadamaya Krishna prema padayate Krishna Krishna chaitanya karunate sokrati namo namaha E Krishna karunasindho Dina vandhu chanate Mokresa mokadhanata Adhananda namo sute Tattakam sanyo vandhi Radhe vandhava vishwade Vrishabhavu sute devi Pranamami karitviye Shri Krishna chaitanya Prabhu nityananda Shri Advaita Gadadhara Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Krishna Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare.
Om Namo Bhagavate Vasudevaya. understood. Translation by His Divine Grace, Sri Aisi Bhakti Vinanda Swami Prabhupada.
Yeah.
ISKCON Founder Acharya.
Yeah.
Vasudeva said, "My Lord, You are the Supreme Person, beyond material existence, and You are the Super Soul. Your form can be perceived by transcendental knowledge, by which You can be understood as the Supreme Personality of Godhead. I now understand Your position perfectly." Vasudeva said, My Lord, You are the Supreme Person.
You are the Supreme Person.
Beyond material existence.
Beyond material existence.
You are the Super Soul.
You are the Super Soul.
Your form can be perceived by transcendental knowledge.
Your form can be perceived by transcendental knowledge.
By which You can be understood.
By which You can be understood.
As the Supreme Personality of God. I now understand Your position perfectly. End of translation, beginning of purport by His Divine Grace, Sri Aisi Bhakti Vedanta Sai Prabhupada.
Yeah.
Within Vasudeva's heart, affection for His Son and knowledge of the Supreme Lord's transcendental nature both awakened. In the beginning, Vasudeva thought such a beautiful child has been born, but now Kamsa will come and kill him. But when he understood that this was not an ordinary child, but the Supreme Personality of Godhead, he became fearless. Fearless! Regarding His Son as the Supreme Lord, wonderful in everything, he began offering prayers appropriate for the Supreme Lord, completely free of fear of Kamsa's atrocities. He accepted the child simultaneously as an object of affection and as an object of worship by prayer. Thus in the Bhaktivedanta Swami translation purport to the Srimad Bhagavatam 10th canto, 3rd chapter, 13th verse, in the matter of the birth of Lord Sri Krishna. So this is most wonderful realization Vasudeva had. He gained transcendental knowledge and he could realize the Supreme Personality of Godhead. First he thought this was his son and he was just worrying that how will he be protected from the atrocities of Kamsa. Now Kamsa will come. I'll have to hand him over to Kamsa as I promised. And then Kamsa will kill him. In this way, naturally, Vasudeva was feeling very, very bad. But now he has realized that his son is the Supreme Personality of Godhead Bhagavan. He is the all-powerful Supreme Lord. And so now he has become fearless. He has become fearless. He has become fearless. Rivo! Vajadure mana sinanda nandana avaya charanada vintade. We worship the Supreme Personality of Godhead, Krishna, and also we can become fearless. Become fearless, knowing the protection of the Lord. Vasudeva was a devotee, he knew that Krishna could never be harmed. Bhagavan is transcendental to the material nature, so material problems and material harm don't touch the Supreme Lord, who is fully transcendental. Once he realized that, and he was feeling very, very determined, very fearless. Okay. Come sit in the lap. Our Devaki, as a mother, she's still feeling a little bit fearful. Prabhupada says that just like Devaki was feeling fearful, we should also be like that, very cautious for protecting our Krishna consciousness. We should protect our Krishna consciousness like Devaki and Vasudeva wanted to protect their son. So now, Vasudeva, when he realized it's the Supreme Lord, he started offering prayers. So Vasudeva, you see, when Nandamara, he doesn't know Krishna's God, he just takes care of Krishna as his son. So Vasudeva, he has to know the Lord is the Lord, otherwise he can. So many pastimes can happen. He has to take Lord Krishna over to the Nanda Maharaj and the village. He has to be fearless. So many things are there. So all these things are perfect. Nanda Maharaj doesn't need to know that the Lord Krishna is the Lord. He just thinks this is my son and he enjoys the childhood pastimes. Our childhood pastimes, the parents have to sometimes scold the child, sometimes instruct the child, sometimes bring the child here and there. You think that if I don't feed my child, the child is going to die. If I don't watch the child, some harm can happen. Right, Maharaj? So if you think your child is Supreme Lord, all omniscient, all powerful, then how can you feel that he is dependent on your care? It would be very disruptive for a Vatsalya Ras to know your son is God. And the whole fun would be lost. Like the parents are always watching their children, father and mother taking turns, never letting their child untended for a second. Yesterday, 2 days ago, in Penang, you were sitting there and one child ran out into the street and you pointed out, look here, the child was in the street. And the parents were spacing out and they had to run and get the child. Maharaj was very observant. But if you thought the child was Supreme Lord, you'd be like, it's like Superman, right? You know? So, Carl, nothing could happen to him. So, that fun of taking care of the Lord is there because they think he's dependent on me, he's my ward, I have to protect him. So in that rasa, they don't know that word is Lord. So that's why Vasudeva, he couldn't enjoy the childhood pastimes. He wasn't in the right mood. We had to know the word of that. Still somehow, he's feeling affection. And he's feeling respect. It's also kind of something unusual. I mean, to have parental affection at the same time respect. But it's a little inhibited, but it's there both. He's feeling very much affection to the Lord. He's calm, he's leading my son. And he's so beautiful, and such a wonderful child. At the same time, he's the Supreme Lord, and he's offering these beautiful prayers. Krishna gets more and more, he gets more enjoyment when the devotee is just offering spontaneous devotion without on reverence. On reverence, okay, he also accepts it, but he gets more happiness when the devotee just treats him like Krishna, sit down. Somebody's telling me what to do. Somebody's all the time he's bossing him. He's telling everybody what to do. He's organizing everything. Supreme Lord. So that devotee out of love is caring for him, taking care of him. That gives him some special blessings, some special nectar. Chajak Namal Dev Subhadraki, Nitai Gorki. So, Navam is offering prayers. And he'll be offering prayers for a number of verses and saying, maybe this is verse 3 up till verse 13, up till verse 23. The 10 verses he's offering glories. Then Sukadev gives a little introduction, and then Devaki offers. She's very much afraid of Kamsa. Oh, she'll be going out offering prayers, and Devaki is worried, you know, come on, Kamsa. This demon's gonna come here and harm my son. So she prays. And she offers prayers. She said, you think that you're invisible. Vishnu, you're visible. So for those with material eyes, let me be invisible. I'm worrying about the simple Kamsa. Let's find out which of the birth from my womb. And they wanted him to take a human form so she can hide him somewhere. Prabhupada said, although Devaki is not on the Vrindavan platform, she is near the Vrindavan platform. On the Vrindavan platform, the mother of Krishna is Mother Yasoda, and on the Mathura and Dwarka platform, the mother of Krishna is Devaki. In Mathura and Dwarka, the love for the Lord is mixed with appreciation of his opulence. But in Vrindavan, the opulence of the Lord is not exhibited. Opulence of the Supreme Personality of Godhead is not exhibited. Opulence, the majesty, there it's just kept very simple. Like a cowherd boy. He is a cowherd boy. It's plain. In the Swayambhuva millennium, you are known as Krishna, and Vastudeva was known as Sutapa. Tells how she was benedicted. He wanted a son exactly like me. He asked for a blessing. I want a son exactly like you. And there's nobody exactly like Krishna, other than Krishna. So Krishna became her son. So we saw how Prabhupada, he took his service to the ISKCON movement, he also took care that ISKCON was just like a small child. He was always concerned about it. He was caring for it and protecting it. He said sometimes, I remember sitting in the room one time, he was sitting there and he had his head looked at me. He said, "You don't know what it's like to manage a worldwide spiritual movement." The Prabhupada was taking so much headache to protect the Krishna conscious movement. So now the headache has to be taken by the other leaders, the GBCs, the sannyasis, like His Holiness Bhakti Pujanandana Swami Maharaj, the senior sannyasi, temple presidents, the regional secretaries, the senior devotees. You see that the movement goes on, the Prabhupada's legacy is preserved. This is also like protecting the baby. Hare Krishna movement is also kind of like a baby. He needs to be watched, needs to be cared for. You see that things are going on, all of a sudden some senior devotees start having some argument, things get disrupted. These things happen without expectation. Just like the bamboos hit each other in the wind and cause fire. So this kind of disturbances or sometimes happen. Somebody might be falling into some kind of influence of Maya. So always keep the eyes open and help to protect the devotees. Take the movement. The Prabhupada said that this ISKCON movement was his body. He's also taking care of the movement. It's like taking care of doing some Bapu Seva, serving Prabhupada's body. Viviti is his heart, ISKCON is his body, and the money is his blood. Different things he said like that. So, we're caring for the ISKCON movement. That's all the service we can do for Srila Prabhupada. To make it healthier, to make it strong, to make the movement stronger. To make it what Prabhupada wanted it to be by Maya's arrangement, we're finding out good in some ways, what our defects are, what our weaknesses are, we have to work on it and improve it so that we don't remain under influence of any kind of Maya. Kali is there to always attack our movement to keep it going for 10,000 years. It requires some constant care. It's not going to happen without any concern. Sometimes the devotees, they get upset. They say, why are there so many tests? Why are there so many challenges? But this is a part of the growing. It's like a parent expects that there's going to be so many things going to happen to the child. You have to expect that as this kind of grows, there'll be so many different things which are going to happen. We just have to also grow with them and take care of these different challenges that come up. Today in India, the Bangalore case comes before the Supreme Court for final arguments. If anyone would like to say a little prayer, then Krishna would please give a favorable result for the pro-GBC so we can get an early solution to these problems.
be welcome.
Sometimes unexpected problems come, eventually some solutions come. Tonight, got exhibition notice, but they also got land. This temple had here in KL had a permission for worship in 1987, but then it lapsed. Nobody renewed it. There have to be all these little details, you know, like what the laws are in each place. Local management has to become really alert. Technically, we don't have the, you know, we found in the Lima, Peru, they have a registration as a religion, but according to the law, you have to somehow renew it every year or two. They also fail to renew it. Then Devamita Maharaj really came there and realized that it wasn't being renewed. Like America, once you're registered, it's for life, and you don't have to renew it, but some places they have renewal clauses. Just to create more bureaucracy or something, I don't know why. Like once you're born, why you have to renew your birth? But anyway, I have to know all these details. Someone may say this is all mundane. I want to just chant. I don't want to bother with all these things. But for preaching, we have to do these things. It's part of our seva. It's like a parent has to do for their children, we have to do for the movement. Whether we're a sannyasi or a brahmachari or whether we're a vihasa, somebody has to see for all these things. Of course, like in the Chopati, they organized that all the vihasa community, they took responsibility for all these type of things and left the brahmacharis for preaching. That's the vihasas come forward and take that type of responsibility, I don't think the brahmacharis will complain. Has to be that desire. I'm taking so much headache for my family, let me take some headache for Krishna. I'm taking so much trouble for my material life, let me take some trouble for Krishna. This is the seva. And in the childhood lila of Krishna, you see that the parents, they're always trying to protect Krishna. Actually, Krishna protects himself, but the parents think that they have to protect him. So in the same way, although we have to protect this God from so many challenges, actually Krishna protects it. This is not different from Krishna. But we have a pastime that we have to do it. We have to go through the motions of protecting, but somehow things work out by Krishna's mercy. So these are interesting pastimes to see how the parents of Krishna. Now these are Vasudeva, we can understand there's two kinds of parents, Vrindavan parents and Mathura Dwarka parents. Somebody asks why Vasudeva didn't have a childhood. Now you can understand because he's a parent who also appreciates the opulence of the Supreme Lord. For Nanda Maharaj and Soda, they don't have any understanding about opulence of the Supreme Lord. They just love Krishna as their baby, their child, as their son. No opulence. So that's the Vrindavan mood. And this other is the Mathura and Dwarka mood. So this is a subtle difference. That's why there's two sets of parents. Vrindavan mood parents and Mathura and Dwarka mood parents. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare. Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare.
No, Professor Krishna book, Devaki was worshipping Krishna at the Netherlands, you know.
Yes.
And then Krishna took him to the yoga mall and see him as Krishna.
Yes, she has both. Motherly affection plus some respect. in the Goshini now. But Yashoda knows no idea about opulence of Krishna. Only the loving like child, mother and child. That's the Vrindavan mood. Anybody came on Vrindavan, they're not interested in Krishna is God or He's got all the opulence of power. They like the sweetness of Krishna. His natural sweet beauty in Vrindavan. Hari Bol! Hari Bol!
Vrindavan Brahma Bhattan mentioned that so much transcendental insight is about his
family. Yes. Prabhupada said that. There are so many transcendental anxieties about his family. So we have to pick up. Any other questions? Krishna Balaram Dasa is raising and lowering his head. So how can I know he wants to ask the question? Now he's lowering it, now he's raising it.
After a couple of years they leave the moon, they become very materialistic. Start becoming very materialistic. Who is like this? They are very strong. After a couple of years they leave the moon. They only come there once in a while and then they become very materialistic. Yesterday night we had a class from the Swami Bhāgavatam Maharaj. And once you have a spiritual path and start chanting, your bigger desires will start to make you go to the path.
Yes. And the spiritual path, your material desires will start to leave. So you don't want to go halfway and stop. Chanakya says that the disease, death and fire in the house should be completely finished. Not happen. Say there's a fire burning. Put off 90% of the fire, leave 10% of the fire. Get the flame out and burn it. You put it all the way out. If you have a debt, if you don't pay it back, the interest will start to build up again. Pretty soon you'll find again and again a big debt. So like that, disease, if you have a disease and you don't fully cure it, again you're a little careless, it can come back again, relapse. So they are only in the curing stage now. They're not fully cured. They have to fully cure and they'll be fully saved. They only went partial rate and they got careless again, bad association, offenses, some. And then again the disease increased. So we cannot be proud that I'm doing my devotional service now for 14 months or 13 days and therefore I'm already my Paramahamsa. I've been doing it for 3 years, 27 weeks. Until we get to the final back to Godhead, there's no relaxation. It's like when you're flying, you have some aircraft, airlines, veterans here, and employees in our movement. Say the flight is going from Kuala Lumpur to Los Angeles. So when should the plane let down? Halfway or all the way? Why not take a little rest in the middle of the Pacific Ocean? They're going halfway and they want to take a break. What is it? You can't, there's no halfway, you have to go all the way. We're going over the ocean of birth and death, you have to completely get to the other side, then you land. Then you're okay. Some people, they're not, somehow they don't have that determination. They said, Prabhupada, he considered. Sometimes someone said, look at this new devotee, he's very enthusiastic, very fired up. Prabhupada would say, you know, like, not okay. But he took it more important, who was serving longer? Because for a short run, you can spring a little bit and show some enthusiasm. Then after some, but then that can be also by repulsing awe or by so many factors that somebody is just showing a little bit of enthusiasm. Whether they'll sustain that will depend on their faith, their determination, their commitment. Everything, you see, when you do something in the beginning, it's easy because it's all new. So in the beginning, people show a lot of enthusiasm because it's something new and exciting. But maybe the lust is there, Krishna says, in the senses, the mind and intelligence. So say that they're getting a lot of appreciation. Maharaj gave them a big sweet. Sineshwar said, you're the best Sankirtan devotee. Their name was read out in the morning class several times, and they're feeling like the top of the world, that they're the best in the whole unit. But then some other Sankirtan devotee says, doing better. He gets the Mahaprasadam. Then somebody takes their gamsha, or somebody steals their shoes, or something happens. Then they start going in, and their motivation may not have been pure. So some little things happen, and then you find that they're depressed. Maybe devotional service not so great after all. Because they're very still on the superficial, they're very profound. Whether happiness or distress, whether fame, infamy, all whether difficulties or easy. That we're determined to do our devotional service, that's the test. If somebody gets through all those stages and they're still enthusiastic, then we can understand it's a mature devotee. Otherwise, sometimes things just going easy. That's why we need the test. We have to prove that, yes, I'm going to remain fixed even if it's sometimes difficult. Because life is sometimes difficult. If we don't have that determination, then how will we make it all the way back to Krishna? Time of death is the most difficult. Just like you have sometimes during the wartime, you have fire drills and bomb raid drills and things like that, just to get people practice. And what if there's a bomb? Where to go? During the Cold War, people have nuclear bomb shelters and things like that. Now they don't know what the terrorism, where the attack can come. Like the government doesn't want to say, but if there's a biological attack, most of the people, they don't have that. They don't have that. It would cost billions and billions and billions of dollars to give everyone this vaccine. And for all these different times. They're very quietly vaccinating all the government officers and the big police, according to some reports. Just telling the people nothing to worry about, you know. Because if everybody makes a mad rush, they don't have that much vaccine, they don't have the infrastructure. So some people, they're buying gas masks. What if there's chemical attack? In Israel, they issued everybody gas masks. They're not thinking, they know it. Whatever they have, they can throw it at us. So they have gas masks. I don't know if they give them a vaccine or not. Probably. They're prepared. So then we have to be more like prepared. This is the dangerous place we're in, mature world. So some people, they were doing very good and they're having trouble. We should somehow go to them and encourage them to, oh, come on, come back, we're a good devotee. Try to show them we care. You know how the mind works. I was doing so much service. Then I just so what? I mean, a little bit, maybe I'm just smoking now or doing this and that, but you know, I'm still in my heart, I'm a great devotee. But all these people, they don't appreciate, nobody even once called me. Nobody asked me, how am I doing? They don't care for me. You know, the mind, it's just only people like the mind goes in all these things, so call it. Because the mind works like that, you know. Say, Prabhu, come on, what happened, Manaji? You're doing so much service, we need you. Whether they come or not, at least they know, okay, somebody called, somebody cares. Because that's how the mind works. We should be so mature that we are determined. So all the secretary just leave everything and walk off automatic mode. That's how it went. I lost one camera and the secretary leave everything, they walk off, so some thieves are nobody on. Take it with
you. I take it with you, I don't
I don't say that, but they don't leave everything. You don't know if they're leaping over a table.
It's running, I checked.
What is it like running? I did turn it over, is it like?
Other side is empty or full? First of all, you need to learn the mentality of people. You should be so determined whether Guru smiles at me or whether he gives me a cookie or not, or whether there was one girl, she was so frustrated in Melbourne. Someone told me she's ready to move, I said, why? She said she thinks that Guru doesn't love her. So then I say, I'm the Guru. So then I called her over and said, what happened? How are you? I'm my goodness, Guru's daughter, everything. Then she confided at one time in those days that the Guru Puja, she came for the Guru Puja and somehow I didn't give her a cookie. In the rush, you know, sometimes so many hands or something, somehow I missed to give her. She thought I purposely didn't give her because I don't love her. This happened apparently twice. And one time I was chanting japa with my eyes half closed and she walked by and she thought that I was like purposely not looking at her. So she had convinced herself that actually these things all were like totally unconscious on my side. I didn't consciously do any of these things. But she was convinced that I no longer loved her and therefore I should leave the Krishna consciousness. So people are so sensitive now. Used to be that the Guru would sit there and the chalas are just waiting. Unless the Guru asks, the chala won't eat. He'd be starving. Until the Guru called Guru asked, won't take the shot, they won't eat.
Thank you.
I see, sir, the boy is a little attention there. So you don't know whether it's right or attention or not. Actually, they should be strong enough to go on their own now. Sometimes they need that support. Sometimes it's hearing offensive things. Sometimes it's bad association, friends, because sometimes it's the ego is lost. Hospital problems, so if you see people getting sick again, it's not a surprise. But you want to see some people get cured, that's what's good. So as doctors, you see that a patient has got sick again, you have to go out sometimes and you have to help nurse that patient back to health. Otherwise they may get some fatal disease. I greatly appreciate it. Some fatal diseases that one of the people that they just have a little bit of a cold now, they're a little bit weak, they're not coming regularly, they're not changing anyway. So you go and get them back into the fire, otherwise they may meet some other representative of mine and get some fatal disease and then totally be discovered. Keep converting into some other path. Not favorable. But since you asked the question, Brahma Maharaj likes it, Brahma Maharaj likes to make a comment. Why do people who are strong sometimes get weak?
Thank you for watching our videos. Be sure to subscribe to our channel. We publish new videos every day, and don't forget to like and share our channel.